It is day two of the earth moving adventure. So yesterday we pulled out stumps. Well, what I did was is I kind of cleaned up brush along the side, and the contractor and his helper, they took the excavator and they pulled out stumps. So I cut some firewood and I cleaned up around the edges, and then kind of made sure they answered questions as they need them. And then today we're going for day two. So let me show you what we accomplished yesterday. One of the projects we're working on is to have a view from our campsite. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you kind of where we were gonna have the view, and then we'll walk down and see what kind of trees we're gonna have to cut in order to do that. It's a beautiful morning. It's so nice watching the sun come up from over the mountains. Let me turn around and let you see that. So I was sitting here a minute ago in my chair, and I'm watching this sun come up over the mountains. Kind of thinking about what it's going to look like when we have a view back here and we can do this without the trees in the way. So let's walk down and take a look. As you can see, we've made a lot of progress. And it's these stumps are out. And next step is to go after these water lines and grade everything. And then the step after that is going to be to mow it. So one of the things that seems to be a fact of life is that you look at a spot like we were earlier, you think, wow, I won't have to cut that many trees. But then you start looking and trying to cut trees, and you realize that there's a boatload of trees in the way. And they look a lot smaller up there. You can kind of see where I was just sitting, right? Way up there. They definitely look smaller there than they do when you get out here. So I think what we're gonna try to do, well, first thing we'll have to do is we'll have to clear a spot farther down, because one of the challenges with cutting trees in this situation is that you have a lot of snags, and a snag is where a tree doesn't fall to the ground, it gets caught on the way down. And so what we'll have to do is to find a spot where we can drop a couple of trees, and then we'll drop trees into the spot that those trees left. And then once we get a row of trees all the way across, then we can start dropping trees into that row, and then we'll roll our way up. So you can see there's a lot of trees in the way. Going to take a little bit of work, but I think this view will be pretty spectacular when we're done. You see, there's right up here is where we were sitting, or I was sitting. You can see these big beautiful trees, and what we'll do is we'll cut the small scrubby ones first, and so the small scrubby ones we'll cut, and then take a look and see what is left. That way the big pretty nice ones we can just leave. So now the idea and the goal here is to have it to where when you drive from either side, that this to the edge, kind of the edge of the bank, is weed-eated and mowed and nicely done. So you drive up and you see this really nice spot in a remote location, and you go, wow, I want to camp there. It's kind of where we're heading with this, so that everybody can enjoy their experience. Got kids that like to camp, and I like to camp, and my wife likes to camp. And then we'll also make it available to some of the overland and four-wheel drive groups, and maybe eventually make it available to the general public. But this is my view this morning. So, and it's a little messy right now, but we'll sow some grass seed. Once that grass takes off, you won't even, it'll look very, very different. It'll look very nice and pastoral up here, hopefully. All right, in a few minutes, it'll be time to get started and go to phase two of this. I'll take some video and pictures and we can see how it looks. It's so quiet up here. Just me and the birds and the occasional deer and critter. And the sunrise. So, yesterday there were giant holes where they pulled out stumps. And today, those stumps now reside, or most of them, almost all the big pieces. Those stumps now reside in a nice little line down here at the edge of the woods. Kind of had a dilemma, because if we had burned the stumps, which would be fine, the problem being that it would take days for the core to burn. And I can't stay just to let stumps burn. So what we did was we made a pile, and these are poplar. So with all the dirt off the stumps should rot pretty quick. We're going to test that theory and see. As you can see, there was a lot of stumps. We cut 58 trees. Right now there are, I don't know, maybe 8 small stumps that we haven't pulled up yet. But, and there's a couple of big ones that we decided to leave, and we're going to have to treat those and rot those in the ground. The bad thing about doing that is eventually we'll have to go back and fill those holes in, because where we've... the ones we've left, we're leaving, they will, once they rot, they'll leave a depression in the ground. So we'll need to fill that in. But that's not a big deal. Another example of ones we had to leave were right beside the tree here. And so what you can see is that this is very close to the tree. So if we use the excavator to pull this stump out, then there's a really good chance we'd kill the tree. So I was thinking, my plan was to save that tree, so we had to, we're leaving that stump. We had a couple of big ones that were a really big pain to get out, and I think we're going to do the same thing with this one. And this one we'll chemically treat and rot it in the ground. And same thing here, this one we'll cut it off, treat it, and leave it in the ground. So let me show you what this looks like now. You can see that there was a lot of stumps that came out from where these trees had grown up. You can see where we're starting now to smooth this out. And kind of the plan is to come back here today, and we'll drop water lines in. What I'm going to do is put a yard hydrant, what I plan to do at least, is to put a yard hydrant somewhere right, let's just walk over there. We'll put a yard hydrant about here where this stick of wood is, and then this becomes 2 tent sites. So one site is to the left, just, and then the other tent site will be right here. I need to cut this log up too. Missed that one.
So this is the end of the second day. Contractor's coming back tomorrow to pick up his equipment and to fill in the holes in the ditches. Do the last little bit of grading and it's done. It's definitely been a busy 2 days. Whew. So we've done a bunch of stuff. Let me kind of share. We've done we added 3 yard hydrants. Well, replaced and moved one, added 2 more. You can see here's the pipe. See down in the hole. Just did a little pressure testing, and these are freeze proof. So that means that when you turn off the water, it drains out a hole in the bottom. You can kind of maybe see a little drip right now, or still dripping out. So that's the first one. So this will eventually be 2 campsites with water between them. And then this will be a 3rd campsite, which is going to be a little bit of grading tomorrow to make a flat spot for a tent. You can see in the ditch here. And you can see a very different look now. Now we can, instead of having to turn a trailer around at the top, we can drop through. So I'm looking forward to that. The other nice add, here's the 3rd spigot. You can see the hose for my shower right here. So here's where eventually we'll be able to turn around once we bring in the gravel. Also stubbed in stub for the outdoor shower. One of my next projects up here, I want to put a permanent shower so we can come in and just take a shower. Be a stall, real simple. Here's the 3rd spigot. There's kind of a story about the height of the spigot, but it can be kind of, I don't know if that's a bad thing. Be harder to back into with it being taller. And the other nice add is that there's now a spot, extra spot for a very large tent, or 2 smaller tents, or 2 medium-sized tents, or a cabin. So I think we're getting ready for the cabin. This is got all these stumps out. A lot of stumps came out. I think we've got 5 stumps we're gonna have to treat chemically or remove that way, because they're closer to trees. But we can't really dig them out. But here we are. And thrilled to death. Just happy. Get some grass seed down on it, and then life's good.